It's a trick I've taught a lot of people. It was taught to me by a cocker handler years ago. You want to bring all your hair down. Is this where prep work and combing and all of that comes into play? Because you need to have this hair nice and straight and all combed out. You're going to bring it all the way down. And turn the foot over and pretend that whatever's sticking down or whatever is going to, would be hitting a glass top table, that's what you're going to take off. I don't think that that's a very comfortable way to be, is it? So we're just going to cut this off flat. Don't think about beveling or any of that at this point. Just take this off so this is flat on the table. And then you set this foot down. You really need to stand up for a minute. Okay. And then we're going to hold it down again and just angle our scissors a little bit and just make, go right around that foot, but hold the hair down the whole time. And just go around their foot. Don't expose their toenails or any of that. We just want you to go around at this point. He doesn't want to stand up anymore, do you? Okay, once you do that and you let it go, it's going to come up. Come on, buddy. You need to stand up, hon. Okay, boy. Then what you have left is kind of like a a shelf that you can even use. You can use your curved chunkers on and come around and take that shelf off of there. And your bevel will already be set for you. Okay? Shh. Don't you? Stand, buddy. He doesn't want to stand there. Using this method will get you more uniformity in your bevels. Excuse me. Buddy. Hopefully you can see how that's starting to pop. Now, I have people ask me, well, how come sometimes bevels are way high? How come bevels are way low? Well, generally, the adjustment on the height of the bevels is done because the dog has either got longer legs or shorter legs, and it's done for visual. So, like in a show ring, you might see somebody that has a really high bevel. So don't necessarily think that that's done as a norm. That's done for a reason. The handler has done that to enhance the dog that he wants the judges to see. I'm going to do the back one and use the same technique. Flat off on the table. Nope, nope, nope. Dude. Again, hold the hair down. Usually if a dog is struggling to where his feet placement are, he's not square. And he may not be square for what we want for our purposes, but he's square for himself. So he's trying to get himself back into a position where he's more comfortable. Probably the biggest problem people have, one of the bigger problems that people have grooming cockers is they go into the grooming with a preset idea about cockers, that they're going to be hard to handle, they're going to be nasty, they're going to stinky, they're going to all these things. Cockers and cocky kind of come out of the same derivation, okay? They do not like to be bullied. Sometimes the least restraint on a cocker is your best way to deal with them. If you can get them to cooperate without doing heavy duty restraining on them, sometimes they'll be a lot more cooperative for you. So try that the next time. Try not to prejudge them before they get in the shop. They aren't all bad, they aren't all biters. And you are the educators, and so it should be up to you to educate your clients as to what they need to look for in a breeder and a dog, and what should be proper. It may take some education on your part to convince them to let you leave some hair on the dog. But then again, that's a great opportunity to discuss different kinds of shampoos, maybe more frequent baths and brush outs. Okay, now to set this angle here in the back, what I'm going to do is just grab some of this hair. You notice how he keeps pulling that foot forward. He evidently isn't comfortable for him to be at that position. I'm going to pull this hock hair up like this, out at my angle that I want, and come right back into the foot. Now what that does is that sets my angle coming off my bend in the back leg for what we call a kick out, or that angle of when they move, they're supposed to have a lot of reach and drive. So that accentuates his reach and drive when it's on out like that. Bring it around. Now if he needs some angles built in, we can always do that. We can always go in with our thinning scissors and come into this area, pull some of that out so that that angle lays in a little better. You start to see more angle coming. We can get him to stand there. You'll be able to see that happening. Okay? Gotta see if I can get this going. Wanna make sure we have all the long scragglies off his tail. Don't want anything waving in the breeze when he leaves the shop. We're about done with our time. Let me kind of bring his top knot back a little bit for you so you can get the whole side view. You've got a half-done Cocker Spaniel. Very pretty boy. Thanks.